There's so many different types of these recording apparatus, isn't there?
Yeah.
Amazing. This is like vintage. This is an antique right here. Okay. How are you doing?
So.
Yes.
What drew you to Black Lightning?
First of all, like a strong female character. You know, I think Mara and Salima great at writing women, and I knew if they were involved in the project that the female character would be, all the female characters would be really well fleshed out. So, I mean, for me as an actor, the chance to sort of play a well-rounded character is always an appeal. And then also, how about being part of the first ever black superhero comic on network television? So, I mean, that's pretty impressive and powerful and, you know, historical. So.
Were you familiar at all with Black Lightning before the show?
Not at all. And in fact, I was just telling these guys that, you know, when I grew up in England, we had like a different comic book world, and all the DC stuff kind of came to us by film. So like growing up in the 80s, obviously we had the original like Christopher Reeve Superman, and that was, you know, that was our reference. But our comics in England tend to be like more whimsical and sort of like twee and not really about action. They're quite strange. So this is all completely new, the whole universe, and I actually was lucky enough to get a huge box of Black Lightning comics from DC, and I spent all of 4th of July weekend, much to my kids' disgust, reading the comics, and what I realised is that the universe is infinite, and that's what's so exciting, I think, like when you're telling stories, to know that so many places we could go, and like all the subtle references and the crossovers and this character from this story, and I mean, it's just, I didn't even scratch the surface. So that's exciting to me, to exist in a world that is infinite, you know, and has infinite possibilities. Like, that's what's so magical about comic books and sci-fi, is that there's so many possibilities. So, yeah.
And now, what do you think about the fact that you're part of this superhero show?
I mean, they're super excited. I mean, they're both obviously obsessed, you know, because of China. Is, you know, China's like a god in the kid world. So they're really excited about that. And yeah, I think also for them, as young, you know, African-American girls, they wanted to see themselves represented. And I didn't quite realise how little they were represented until we started doing this and sort of observing like the comic book world and going, oh wait, no, there's no black faces here, you know. So for me, I feel this, yeah, just that is so powerful, to think that sort of a young African-American girl can sit down and go, that's me, that she looks like me, you know. That I just, I'm so excited, you know.
What's it like playing a mother on one of these shows? So often the mothers are absent or dead or sick and dying.
Yeah, no, I'm not going to be any of those things. I mean, you know, I think what's lovely, again, this is a sort of credit to Mara and Salim, is that they write real women. So again, she's not perfect. You know, she's smart. She's got a job. She's a lawyer. But she's made some mistakes. She's on her second marriage. She's just trying to do the best that she can, and then she's got these two daughters who are about to embark on crime fighting. So obviously she's worried. You know, if my kids came home and said, we're getting motorbikes, you know, I wouldn't be okay with it. It's a similar feeling, and I think, you know, I relate to Lynn on so many levels. I think being a woman, being black, you know, trying to just raise young women to do the right thing, I relate to all of them. So I feel happy, because I feel like what we're doing is again something that women can relate to, and not just, she's not perfect, you know, she doesn't have her shit together.
Which characteristics is it important to you to bring out as
I think sort of being a human, and being like, I think that's the contrast, is like they've got these superhuman powers, and on some level she has as well, because I think when you're a mother and a, you know, it kind of is the ultimate superpower. But I think, you know, it's always good to recognise that we are human and we make mistakes and we don't always make the right choices. That's important to me, because I don't want to watch somebody on screen who's perfect and who's got it down and who has the right answers, because that's not who I am. And I'm pretty sure none of you are that either. So I feel like that's what I want to see. I want to see someone who isn't, who is fragile and vulnerable sometimes, and you know, it is not kind of perfect and put together and tough. I think that's important.
How natural was it for everybody the first day on set? Did you guys feel like a family, or did it take
You know what? We kind of did. I know Nafisa and China had a chance to work together in the auditions, and that was pretty instant. But yeah, I'm going to say it was pretty instant. Again, I think that's because of Mara and Salim. I think they've got a good sort of instinct about what works and what they sort of really needed in there, and I think, you know, I think that's why it works really, really well. So hopefully that will come across on the screen.
Sorry, thank you guys. Thank you.
Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.